Hi, hello everyone. This is Harsha. Welcome to our YouTube channel Tech Mahir. Wipro recently made an announcement regarding a national level talent hunt. So regarding that, we have already posted a video on exam pattern, eligibility, chances for turbo challenge, and what are the topics to prepare for the exam and all. So if you haven't watched the video, I have provided the link in description, so you can watch the video there by clicking on the link. And before going into this video, those who are new to this channel or those who haven't subscribed our channel yet, please do subscribe the channel. And in this video, I would like to invite Arshad, one of my friends, to share his experiences regarding Wipro National Level Talent Hunt. So he got placed in Wipro through National Level Talent Hunt and I asked him to share his views and experiences regarding it. So yes, before going into this video, once again I'm requesting that please do subscribe to our YouTube channel. Then we will get the energy to come up with new innovative ideas and new videos and all. So thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Mohammad Arshad. I'm a BTech graduate in ECE from Vignans University, Guntur, and I'm here to share my Wipro's interview experience with all of you guys. So let's get started. I came to know about Wipro's NLTH, which is the National Level Talent Hunt, through my college placement group, and then I applied in the careers website of the Wipro. However, Wipro's NLTH is not an on-campus drive, it's a national level off-campus test, and the eligibility criteria is that the student must belong to the CSIT or the circuital branches with a minimum aggregate of 65% in BTech, and also the student must attain 60% in both 10th and 12th standards. Coming to the written test, it's an online test with a duration of around 2 hours, and there are 3 sections in it. The first one is the aptitude MCQs, and the second one is the written communication test, and the third one is the programming test. So you might have been aware that Wipro conducts NLTH in the AMCAT platform, so which is different than the others. It's like if you give a correct answer to a question, the next question's difficulty will be increased by a bit, and the corresponding points that are going to be awarded to it will also be increased by a bit. At the same time, if you give your answering correctly, the next question's difficulty will be slightly decreased, and also the points will also be slightly decreased for the next question. So nothing to worry about it. It's neither a disadvantage or an advantage. It's a mixed bag, so we have to be aware of that. And coming to the written communication, we'll have 20 minutes to write an essay in English. The topics won't be complex. It can be general topics like social media, education, leadership. So nothing difficulty in the topics. But the way you write will be a bit tricky, so we're going to talk about it in the later half of the video. Coming to the programming test, we'll have 60 minutes to solve 2 coding questions. One of them will be an easier one and the other one will be slightly difficult. So the languages allowed are Java, C, C++ and Python, so you can choose one of them. And yeah, that's about the written test. Talking about my preparation, I was confident with my basic concepts in C, so preparing for the coding part wasn't a huge task for me, but I was feeling less confident when it comes to the aptitude section. So, and moreover, my college has arranged a special training for the people who are attending Wipro's NLTH. So that training has helped me to cover my aptitude training. And coming to the written communication part, just like I told before, yes, it might get tricky sometimes because you will have only 20 minutes to write an essay of around 300 to 400 words, and it's not a human evaluation, obviously, because lakhs of people will be writing the exam and it's not feasible to have a individual correction. So yes, it's gonna be evaluated by AI based system in these kind of exams. So, which can easily determine whether you are going against a topic or you're supporting the topic. So, have a proper stand. Just don't swing at the same time supporting and opposing it. So, gotta have a proper stand on it. And all the grammatical errors, including the punctuation, the spelling mistakes, can be easily identified by the system, and that can give you negative marks at the instance. So, we gotta be very careful about that. And also, the structure of our paragraph can also be judged. So I'm gonna have a nice introduction and then the body in and a few paragraphs in it. And also the paragraphization is also equally important. And proper conclusion is also required. So the system can easily determine whether you have concluded in haste or you had a proper conclusion at the end of the end of your answer. So that has to be taken care of. And yeah, take help from online how to deal with this part of the NLTH. And yeah, coming back to the programming, it's not so easy to advise someone how to prepare a new programming language because it's going to be different from for different people. In my case, I follow a textbook which was prescribed to me by my first year faculty and I make my own notes on it. So that's how it goes with me. And yeah, running around to find new ways to learn programming languages just at the start of an interview or just at the start of a placement drive is not going to help. So just stick to the way that you have been learning from the beginning. Just follow those things from the beginning. So that's going to help. Okay, coming to the interview, there was a gap of 30 to 40 days between the written test and the interview. It also happened in two phases, the technical round and the HR round. And there was an elimination of the technical round. So you have to do well in the technical round to be qualified for the HR round. So my technical round went well. There were questions on the basic concepts of programming. My project details were asked, which I did in my college. And he was impressed with that. We did a project on object detection using drone and machine learning. So he asked more details about it. And then I was moved to the HR round. There was a gap of 4 to 5 hours between that. And the HR wanted to test my communication skills. He wanted to know what were the other things, the extracurricular activities which I was doing in college apart from academics. And there were discussions on the agreement that we were going to sign of 12 months and there were also discussions on the relocation during the job. And yeah, it went well as well. And one thing about the technical interview is that if you are a CSIT student, then you will be tested on various technologies and programming questions. And if you are a circuital branch student, there might be a lesser emphasis on the programming part, but core related questions might be asked. So you might be asked to choose a favorite subject among your core and questions will be confined to that. So even that may happen. So gotta be prepared for that even. Okay, and during my technical interview, the questions were on pointers in C, recursion and function references, and more details were asked about the technologies which we used in our project. And then in HR round, the HR first checked my academical percentages during 12th, 10th and my BTech percentages. He told me that he was impressed with the academic background and asked me whether I did any extracurricular activities during my college. And the fact with me was that I was a regular member in the student activities in college by hosting formal events and organizing events. So that made me, you know, make a good impression during the HR round. And also he made me initially feel comfortable by asking some casual questions like how was the weather outside. It was a Skype call, by the way, so he wanted to break the ice with me and make me feel comfortable. So that's how it happened. My suggestion would be to start early, because considering the amount of competition that's increasing year by year, we need to plan a good strategy for our preparation. And the spoken skills are gonna be equally important as well, because sometimes we might have a strong, confident answer in our head, but it doesn't reach the other end of the table because we might lack the expressing skills. So some of us might be having this problem, and when we notice that we have this problem, we must be taking some action. Yeah, and the college definitely gives us a lot of chances to improve ourselves with the communication skills, and hence that's something that cannot be neglected at any point. And also during the interview, the resume building also plays a major role. Don't go out there with an extravagant resume that uses all the fancy words. You will be digging your own hole if you are adding something which you're not completely aware of. So keep it simple and straight to the point. That will impress the interviewer. And during the interview, don't get tensed and have a confident smile, and everything will be fine. Thank you.